This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back.
You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Where we go from there
is a choice I leave to you.
Get asked a lot of questions about this kayak, how I've set it up and how I go about fishing from it. So I thought I'd dedicate this video clip to showing you around my boat and so you can see how I have rigged it up. A lot of thought and a lot of trial and error has gone into this. I've been lucky, I've had access to a lot of equipment, pretty cheap, sometimes at no cost at all. So I've done a lot of experimenting and this is what I've come up with. Up front there on the hatch underneath the bungee cords there, that's where I like to carry my gaff hook nowadays. It's nice and secure up there, it's a long way away from me, it's pretty easy to get if I need to, and I like the fact that it is a fair way away from me, to be honest with you. Okay. In my front hatch here, I've got a large waterproof bag. It's a big dry bag actually, it's a big roll bag. It's about 75 centimeters long and you can hold some pretty big fish in there actually, bigger than 75 centimeters. Underneath here, I've got a waterproof box. It's actually glued to the bottom of the kayak using marine goop and there's a 12 volt battery in there containing the battery for the sounder. Here we've got my sounder and GPS system. It's a bit of a two in one thing actually. This is the sounder, of course, the Matrix 47. That's a 3D sounder, running it in 2D mode at the moment. It's quite a good unit, actually. And that's a GPS antenna, and that's actually wired up into the sounder here. So I've got both sounder and GPS functionality out of the one unit, which is very handy. The wiring for power and the antenna and whatnot comes out of this screw-in fitting, which all adventures have got, and I've just basically drilled a hole through that and pulled the wires through and used silicon to seal it up. There's ram mounts all over this kayak. It's partly why I decided to call it ramming speed. I've got two B-size balls up on the front deck there. This one's for the sounder. This one I can use to attach a camera if I'm going to use the kayak in hull only mode. That's a pretty good place to put it. I've also got another ram ball attached to the front ukka, which is great for filming footage of bringing in fish, and another one here at the rear ukka, which is great for footage for sailing. I'm quite a fan of the ram fishing rod holders. I think they're excellent for kayaking, and these ones are the ones that I like. In fact, I like most of the ram stuff, but these are the ones that I like the best. They're pretty simple, they give you a lot of range of movement. It's the reels, and rods I should say, are nice and easy to put in and out. You can have the reels facing one way or the other, which I find really quite handy. I like the ability to be able to reach over and just start reeling the line in. That's really handy if you're trawling two lines or drifting two lines, which I'm doing at the moment. If you hook onto a big fish, it allows you to bring in the other line and get it out of your way. I like to carry a Hobie stakeout pole with me. It's quite handy in shallow waters for staking out and anchoring. Quite handy in rivers and estuaries, I find. And offshore, I've actually found it to be sort of reassuring to carry in the case of sharks. And as you can see here, I've also got a ram ball attached to that and some ram mounts for a camera. And the idea of that is to allow me to stick the camera under the pole there and poke it underwater to get underwater footage if I ever get the inspiration. Just at the right side pocket here, I've got a couple of appendages attached, one of them being the fish donger. I've got that actually clipped to the pocket. There's a few clips there, a couple of clips there that I've screwed in, and it just comes out like so. I have actually attached it to the hull with a stainless steel clip, so just in case it does come out, I'm not going to lose it, but it does clip in there pretty solidly, as you can see. Here are my fish grips. These are pretty handy to have, I find. I mean, when I bring in a fish, the first thing I like to do is get it subdued with these grips. The moment you've got a grip on those lips, then you've got much better control of the fish. This one's attached to a Hobie gear keeper here, as you can see. It's retractable. So if I do hook that onto a fish and it happens to leap out over the side, I won't accidentally tramp. This is a handy piece of equipment, and I use it both when I'm sailing and also when I'm using the kayak as an outrigger like I'm doing at the moment. These things are great. They take a lot of weight. You can actually sit out onto those and drift fish, which is really quite nice. You can also use it for rigging, storage of camping gear. You can carry a passenger in the right sort of conditions. And also handy as a fish landing platform, I found. Here's one of the cameras I use. This one catches most of the footage in the clips that I do. That's a Sanyo Zappi, and that's mounted with a couple of RAM sockets. I like to use two or even three. That gives you pretty good ability to move the camera around without having to adjust the position of the bottom brace. I don't like loosening that off at all when I'm out at sea. But with that sort of setup, you can adjust the position of the camera just by lightening off the top one and then moving it into whatever position you need and then tightening it up. It works well. Here is my drink bottle. That's a an Nalgene drink bottle. It's much the same as the one that comes with the Hobie kayaks. This one's actually got a lantern cap on it. That's actually a little torch, so at night or early in the morning, if I hit that switch, my water bottle doubles as a lamp. I use two seat pads. I find that much more comfortable with my bony little butt, especially when I spend hours out here, which I often do. I've changed the clips that they clip to the kayak with. I've gone to a stainless steel buckle there, and I've also added a couple of tri-glide buckles, I should say, to make sure that those straps never ever budge. So the position that I set it, that's the position that it stays in. On the back here, as you can see, I've attached a, well, it's actually a kayak deck bag, and it just happens to be the perfect shape for the back of the Hobie backrest there, as you can see. I had to get creative attaching it. I had to put in a couple of screws in there to attach the thing, but it is pretty handy to have. At the moment, I've just got a towel in there and my binoculars. Sometimes I carry my lunch in there, and I often carry a map case, a waterproof map case, in that front pocket there. I've got three rod tubes at the back. One of them's a RAM, the other two are Hobie rod extender tubes. They're pretty handy to have. I really just use them for storage most of the time. Every now and then I'll trawl out of these ones. I've got rod leashes attached to them. They're actually attached with bungee cords and stainless steel hooks on them. That's obviously to secure the rods in place. I've got one of those here on the RAM one as well. Stored in the rear well here are two fully waterproof boxes. These are completely submersible. They definitely do not leak. This one carries tackle, soft plastic lures, and jig heads, hooks, sinkers, all that sort of stuff. And in here, I've got all of my safety equipment. Bungee down at the back there is my wheel cart. That's the new wide base wheel cart that's come out from Hobie. It secures into place there with the bungee hooking over those collar clamps. It is very, very secure. The shark shield unit that I picked up not long ago, actually, after I had an encounter with a great white shark in these very same waters, and definitely does give me a bit of peace of mind. Pretty easy to install. All I needed to do really with this is just Velcro it down to that rear crossbar, and underneath there, a nice handy position, is that scupper hole, and that's where I feed the antenna through. Carry a few things inside the kayak in the center hatch here. One of them is that box, which I've actually, it's a waterproof box that I've screwed into the hatch lid there, and the idea of that is to carry lures that I've used out here that I don't want to put back into the tackle box because they've got salt water on them, and I don't want them floating around loose in the kayak. I put them in there, they're out of harm's way. In here, that's my trawling lure box. All of the lures that I use for trawling out here, that's where I carry that. Also inside the hatch here is my emergency paddle. It's attached with a paddle leash, as you can see. That's secured inside the hull. This paddle never comes out. I leave it in there all the time. That way I never forget to take it. I don't use it much though. It really is just a backup paddle, but nice to have it.